Welcome to part 3 of my Unitail crash course. In this tutorial, we'll create two different inventory items. The first one will be a simple consumable item which heals the player by 10 HP. The second one will be a weapon which we can equip for a higher damage output. If you want to follow along with everything, watch the first two parts of the series before watching this one. If you're just looking for the solution to a tiny inventory related problem, then just watch the entire tutorial. The solution could be anywhere in this video, plus I get some extra watch time. It's a win-win situation. Also, I'm using Create Your Frisk, which is the new and improved version of Unitail. I'm still going to refer to it as Unitail sometimes. Anyways, let's get right into the code. First, we need to learn how to add items to our inventory. Open the encounter.lua file found in your encounters folder. In this tutorial, we will just add items to our inventory at the start of the battle. To do that, we use this function called encounterStarting. As the name suggests, it is called when the encounter starts. We'll write our inventory code here. First, write inventory, then add a dot, and then write add custom items. The uppercase letters are important here. So what did we just write? We called the function of an object called inventory, which is responsible for handling the in-game inventory. The dot just says that we want to access a function or variable of that object. The function addCustomItems requires two tables. Remember them from last tutorial? The first one contains all of the item names, while the second one contains all of the item types. The first one is self-explanatory, but the second one could use an introduction. It is an integer table. It needs to be of the same length as the first table or there will be an error. Acceptable item types range from 0 to 3. 0 is for a normal consumable item which disappears after it's used. 1 is for a weapon and 2 is for armor. Both can be equipped and boost attack or defense stats respectively. 3 is for a special item, which won't go away on its own after it was used. After you added your items using this function, we need to call another function from the inventory object called setInventory. It requires one table, again with all of the item names. Just copy the first one so you don't make any typos or you'll get another error. Each item needs to do something when it's selected. We specify that functionality in the handleItem function at the bottom. It is very similar to the handleCustomCommand function from part 2. This one, however, receives the item's name that was used instead. The item's name is also in uppercase letters, so keep that in mind. It will be important later. So, let's create our first consumable item. I'm going to call it Cinnamon Bun. Set its item type to 0 for consumable and add its name to both inventory functions. So, let's add an if statement into our handleItem function. Remember them from part 2 as well? I hope so, because this if statement is going to be very similar to the one we wrote for the act commands. I'm not going to explain it in detail again, just the parts that are different. So, we check if the item that was used was called Cinnamon Bun, all in uppercase or else it won't work. If that's the case, we need to heal the player. We do this by first writing player, then adding a dot, and then heal. We put the amount of HP that should be restored in the brackets and done. Just like with the inventory functions at the top, this line calls the heal function of the player object. Check out the Unitail documentation for the rest of the player functions. Now we need to add a battle dialogue function for displaying text in the arena. If you don't add this, then the item can't be selected. And that's it! Unitail will heal the player and play the healing sound. The item will be gone after it was used. Let's create the second item. Add another item name to the inventory functions at the top. I'll call my weapon Rusty Sword. The item type will be 1, so Unitail recognizes it as a weapon. Add another condition to the if statement like the first one, this time starting with else if. To set the amount of damage that the weapon will do when equipped, call the function setAmount from the inventory object. The default value is 20 according to my tests. Let's double it. Add a descriptive battle dialogue and test out your weapon. Your damage should be way higher once the weapon has been equipped. And that's it for this tutorial. The inventory items we added have very limited functionality, but now that you know the basics of creating an item, feel free to use the Unitail documentation to experiment around with different items. Stay tuned for part 4, where I'll explain how to create your own waves. Creator out!